Hello guys, I'm Adriana and today we'll work with this Samsung S21 Ultra with a launch price of 1260 euros. It comes to our workshop because of the water damages, quite a lot of humidity I would say. As you can notice, in the lens we can see that it has water, so we have to open it. We'll use the hot air gun at 90 Celsius degrees during 3 or 4 minutes. We won't be long with the disassembly process, we are going to use the fast camera. The truth is that we have a lot of work and we don't want to waste time. But if you are looking for the disassembly process of this device, you can check on our YouTube channel. As you can see here, we've got very bad news. The device has water in all over the places. We remove the upper antenna and then we lose all the connectors. Do not forget the SIM tray. Here we have the motherboard. It has a lot of water. Before we separate the two motherboards, we are going to proceed with the superficial cleaning process using the contact cleaner. In this way, we remove some humidity. Separate the two motherboards, we apply 425 Celsius degrees and 80% air. This Samsung motherboard is quite thick, so it withstands the temperature very well. The trick is to apply a lot of heat and to move the nozzle without stopping. In this way, we won't damage the plastic connectors, nor will we blow up the other components. It takes a little of practice, but it's easy. In the description of this video, I'll leave you the link from where to buy this professional tool from the Quianli brand. to easily separate any motherboard. Also, this base to hold any motherboard. So, don't forget to check it on the description of this video. If you like this type of content, please give me a strong like, subscribe and share the content. So I'm going to keep uploading real repairs from our laboratory. Thank you. Now I'm gonna leave you another trick. We apply a little bit of flux and we heat the two motherboards again. In this way, we give shape to the solder bolts. If you master this technique well, you don't have to proceed and apply the reballing process all over again. And if you move quickly, you can even take advantage of the heat we use to separate the two motherboards. We'll use the same temperature and the same airflow. 420 Celsius degrees and 80% air. In this way, we recover the original shape of the solder paste. You can see that we have not lost any pad, so the trick is not to remove the upper part abruptly. Now we are going to inspect the second layer. The truth is that the second layer does not have so much humidity, but the big problem is with the upper part. As we are working with a quite oxidated motherboard, we have to apply Tikopur. In this way, we try to remove all the oxide. In this moment, I realized that we've got a lot of burnt circuits and it's impossible to find them. What happens with these devices is that they are quite new and right now we don't have broken motherboards in stock. Having a broken motherboard, we can recycle a lot of components. We take this opportunity and we solder the motherboard manually. I don't have tools either to join these boards, but I don't think I'm going to invest money in buying them. If you can do it manually, we'll do it like that and that's it. Here we have the final result. We can join these motherboards manually without any problems. So let's recapitulate. The camera is impossible to save and the screen is burned. For this reason, to solve this device is more expensive than the device itself. Guys, this was today's video. I hope you like it. Here's Leonardo. Thanks for watching and see you next time. Bye bye.